to Professor Eisenstein. Find out tomorrow, Wide Awakers. It's so exciting! Galaxy High, more from that tomorrow. And, of course, another full adventure on Saturday. But now, Wide Awakers, it's time for this. Okay, Wactors and Wactresses, today we have a wonderful story for you which will be acted out by some of the finest Wactors and Wactresses in the world. Once upon a time, Wide Awakers, in a time before time, in old Thailand, there used to live some very greedy creatures, amazingly called kangaroos. But these weren't kangaroos as we know them today. They didn't hop, they walked around on four legs. Now, these kangaroos were a great big nuisance in Thailand because they used to eat all the Thais off the trees. So one day, the people of Thailand decided to do something about it, and they made a secret plan. One dark, dark night when the kangaroos were full of Thais and sound asleep and snoring, the people sneaked quietly out of their houses and they snuck up on the kangaroos, which used to sleep on their backs with their legs pointing up in the air. When they gathered together the few Thais left and fastened them tightly around the kangaroos' legs. Well, the kangaroos woke up in the morning and tried to stand up, but they found that they couldn't walk around at all as they used to because they were ritually hopping mad. They were tied up with their legs. They wanted some brekkie and they couldn't reach the tasty, juicy Thais hanging from the trees. So the kangaroos went hopping around, hopping mad.
Mad, mad, hop mad, mad.
Absolutely. They hopped around for a bit and in the end they felt so completely and utterly fed up that they decided they'd hop off and find something else to eat. And they hopped all around Thailand. They couldn't find a single thing that they liked on the ground. So they hopped on and 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 on until eventually they hopped all the way to
Australia!
Absolutely! And they liked it a lot there because they found lots of lovely food and the weather was very nice too. And eventually the Thais fell off and the kangaroos decided they liked hopping around like they did. And they didn't want to go back to Thailand where the people have been so unfriendly. And so to this day, that's why kangaroos hop in Australia and there are none to be found in Thailand. And that, Wide Awakers, is also where the famous Thai song comes from.
Tie me kangaroo down, spoke. Tie me kangaroo down.
Absolutely. It's a true story, Wide Awakers. We made it up ourselves. Thank you! Utterly brilliant. Now, Wide Awakers, it's time for our Thailand adventure. And today's a very exciting adventure because we're going to go to somewhere which is very, very common in Thailand. Lots and lots of churches. But the churches in Thailand are quite different to the churches over here. They're Buddhist churches. And you'll find that all the boys become Buddhist monks at some stage during their lives. This is what the churches look like here with these huge, enormous spires. And they're all shaped weird and wonderful shapes like this. And this is what they do during their school holidays. In fact, they go to monasteries. And that's what our story's about today. School holidays, Wide Awakers, and what do? You go playing with your friends and going away on holiday and having loads of fun. What do they do in Thailand? They go to the monastery. Almost every man in Thailand becomes a monk at some stage or other, and it starts very young as 10 years old, for instance. But during the holidays, they'll come and spend a couple of months as a Buddhist novice monk. But then the rest of the time, you'll get all kinds of people coming here to pray. And you take your shoes off. Very important to take your shoes off before you go into a temple. This golden statue here is of Buddha. Now, the Lord Buddha lived hundreds of thousands of years ago, and he was an Indian prince with loads of money who gave it all away to live a quiet and simple life. And that's what these monks are doing here. Twice a day, Wide Awakers, the monks gather here to chant and pray. And they pray for humility and patience to lead a good life. After the monks have finished their chanting and praying, they continue around the monastery to carry on their daily business. This is the marble temple. One of the monks here is Pracha. Hello.
Hello.
How long does it take to become a monk?
4 years.
Now, living here in the temple and around in the monastery here, there are how many monks?
About 150. Ooh. But during the Buddhist reign, about 200.
I noticed, Pracha, that there are only boys here. There are no girls being monks?
Girl cannot become novice and monks. Just only boy.
Okay. Can the girls pray?
Yes.
But they can't become monks?
Yes.
Right.
But if the girl want to obey to practice like a monk and novice, but they can, but not the ways.
So nuns, there is none.
No nuns. Nowadays, no nuns.
No nuns.
But in those times, there were.
There used to be nuns, but not anymore. This is amazing. Wide awakers. Wacaday being played in a monastery in Thailand. Are you sitting comfortably, wide awakers? Then I'll begin. Once upon a time, many moons ago, when I was young and you were even younger, there lived far, far, far away in a far off distant part of Thailand, a monk who was a punk. And the punk monk was very, very impatient. He was always in a hurry. He was first to get up in the morning, and he would rush through washing and rush through getting his breakfast and rush back to go praying and rush through lunch and rush through the praying again. He could do the whole lot before 6 o'clock in the morning. And then he would sit around the rest of the day saying, I'm bored! I want things to happen now! Until one day, the abbot said to him, Punk monk, you must slow down. Why? Said the punk monk. Because then you will see much, much more. So the following day, the punk monk got up slowly, washed behind his ears slowly, and went out to get his breakfast from the locals. And just at that moment, who should come up but little Tai Chi, whose birthday it had been the day before. And Tai Chi said to the punk monk, would you like some of my birthday cake from yesterday? And the punk monk was absolutely delighted. Chocolate cake was his favourite. And if he'd hurried, like he had every other day beforehand, he would have missed that chocolate cake and it would have gone to somebody else. So he had chocolate cake for breakfast and chocolate cake for lunch. And he was a very, very happy, slow punk monk. And the moral of the story, wide awakers, is always take your time. And then you too might get some chocolate cake for breakfast. It's a true story, wide awakers. I made it up myself.
Chocolate cake for breakfast. Are there many of those monks, Timmy?
Yeah, there's an amazing amount of them, because all over Thailand, everybody becomes a monk at some stage or other.
And they all wear orange.
Yep, bright
so,
orange.
So, you two, if they all wear orange, what are they?
Monks.
You said it first, so come on, you go!
Pair of choppy chopsticks for you.
It took a long time to get that, didn't it, today? That is time for the brilliant game.
Right, it's time for the one ton of one ton soup game. Let's go to the phones and say hello to Sunil.
Hi.
Hi, hello. Where are you calling from?
Gansfield.
Right, in Ilford in Essex.
Yep.
Excellent Essex. Okay, I'll put you on to Stephen here. Hang on. It's Sunil.
Hello, Sunil.
Hello.
Where are you going for your holidays?
Nowhere.
Aww. Will you be watching Carly tomorrow?
Pardon?
Will you be watching Carly tomorrow?
Yeah.
Carly's on tomorrow, good.
Okay, do you want to put that out there?
Who do you want the mystery person to be?
My brother.
Mm.
Oh, dear.
What's your brother called, Sunil?
Sandeep.
Okay, Sandeep it's going to be, and then...
No, just tip it in.
Whole lot.
Oh. Is your brother bigger than you?
Yeah, much.
Oh, you'll be in big trouble then if he gets slow.
Pour it all in. It's bright, bright green soup. Do you like green soup?
No.
No, good. Neither will your brother. Lovely. All you have to do is to answer all the questions and we'll chop away the choppy chopsticks. So let's begin with the first one, Sunil. Colour TVs produce only three colours, true or false?
False.
Actually, it's true. Three colours and they get all mixed up together and that's why you have colour telly. So we can't chop one away. If you have collie wobbles, you're angry with your cauliflower, true or false?
False.
False is a good answer, so you can chop one away. and three of them fell over. Dogs, no, hang on. Ice cream was invented in 1620. True or false? Ice cream was invented in 1620.
True.
True's a good answer, so chop it away.
One away.
Go on. Go on! Okay, and in Thailand, only boys can become monks. True or false?
True.
True's the right answer! Pleased with that now, Sunil?
Yep.
Thought you would be. This is your utterly wacky prize. It's your bowl of splurgy green soup collection, which and you'll be getting.
I think they're going to sing a song now. I tell you what, do you want to sing it, Georgina? A song by Bros?
No.
No? What do you mean? Too much love.
Too much love.
Let's have some look at some Wac Snaps this morning, Wide Awakers, with Bros. This morning, Wide Awakers, and if you want to have your photo on the telly, all you have to do is take your photo of yourself making a wemote or a wacky snappy, and you send it into Wacaday, TDAM,
PO Box 200, London, NW1 HTQ.
Now, in a moment, we'll tell you what's happening tomorrow and what you have to be doing to watch tomorrow's Wacaday. That's all in just a moment.
Wacaday,
Wacaday, Wacaday.
If Kevin, my fruit bat, hears me say, Roundtree's fruit gums, he's got to have one, because he loves fruit, and my Roundtree's fruit gums are very, very fruity. Still, I think I've got away with it.
Roundtree's fruit gums, they're very, very fruity.
Hang on to your new Sunland News of the World bingo card, me hearties. Over a million more to win. So keep it handy. New Sun Bingo starts soon.
Next week, the stars of the movie the whole country's talking about join us on TVAM. On Monday, Hollywood's favourite actress, Kim Basinger, tells us about playing the Cape Crusader's girlfriend. Batmania continues when Michael Keaton swoops in to talk to David Foster. Wednesday, Paul Gambaccini tells us what he really thinks of the movie that has broken box office records. And on Thursday, glamorous Jerry Hall appears in the studio to update us on her acting career. All the brightest stars appear on TVAM.
Tomorrow, Wide Awakers, it's Kylie Minogue and Timmy Bond, the James Bond story. So you have to watch tomorrow
with your neighbour.
Have your neighbour watching the show tomorrow, OK?
Or if you've not got a neighbour, or she's wearing a holiday or something like that, then you have to have a Timmy Bond water pistol!
Yes, make sure you're ready for that.
And annoy everyone all day long.
Absolutely. That's tomorrow on Wacaday, Wide Awakers, the show your telly was made for.
Bye! Wacaday,
Wacaday!